Hello, hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Okay, let us start with the mechanism of absorption digested substances. How digested substances which are absorbed and how what type of mechanism which is involved in the digestive system of the animal, especially human beings. Let us see. We know very well the digestive particles such as carbohydrates and proteins, nucleic acids, and finally lipids. These are the macromolecules. These macromolecules are converted into the micromolecule or individual substances through the digestive system. Okay, carbohydrates are the glucose, galactose, and fructose. Proteins that converted into the amino acids, dipeptides, and tripeptides. Nucleic acids that converted into the nitrogen bases and pentose sugar and inorganic phosphate. Coming to the lipids, lipids that converted into the short length fatty acid, short length fatty acids and small length fatty acids, long length fatty acids, monoacylglycerols and glycerol. Okay, in this way, these are the micromolecules that are produced by the human digestive system from the carbohydrates. Let us see what type of transport system which are essential for the transportation of the these moieties from the intestinal lumen into the microvilli, especially microvilli cells, from where to the blood and lacteal, especially lymphatic vessel. So let us see. You just assume this is a microvilli cell. Microvilli cell. These microvilli cells that connected with the blood vessel. So this area from here to here, this area, complete this area. This is called as a lumen of small intestine. This is the microvilli cell, especially it is the epithelial cell. Epithelial cell. These epithelial cells that directly contract or connected with the blood vessels. So, these epithelial cells that directly connected with the blood vessels. Okay. Let us see, first of all, with the carbohydrates. Initially, you can see glucose galactose that transported from the lumen into the epithelial cells through a transportive system that is a secondary active transport, especially SimPort. I already discussed what is the SimPort. Here, the glucose galactose that transported through the SimPort along with the mineral that is called as a sodium. We know very well, in this SimPort, higher concentration to the lower concentration and lower concentration to the higher concentration. Here, glucose galactose are the higher concentration that enter into the lower concentrated site, that is the epithelial cell. Coming to the sodium, sodium at lower concentration, this lower concentrated sodium that transported into the higher concentrated sodium. So, the next is a fructose. Fructose sugar is transported from the lumen into the epithelial cell through the facilitated diffusion. But here we have to remember, here glucose and galactose, here is fructose, which all are present in the epithelial cells. These epithelial cells must be transport these substances into the bloodstream. So let us see, these two substances that enters into the bloodstream through the facilitated diffusion. The fructose also enter into the bloodstream through the facilitated diffusion. Okay, so in this way, glucose, galactose, fructose that are transported from the lumen into the epithelial to the blood. Okay, next. Proteins, especially amino acids. Amino acids transported from lumen to the epithelial cells through the secondary active transport, SIMPOT actually. In the SIMPOT, these transport along with the protons, along with the H plus ions are protons. We know H plus ions here is a low, amino acid here is a high to low, low to high. That is called as a SIMPOT. Here amino acids, these amino acids that enter into the bloodstream through the simple diffusion. So amino acids, secondary active transport SIMPOT from the lumen to the epithelial cells. In the epithelial cells that are transported to the bloodstream through the simple diffusion. Similarly, you can see the nucleic acids. Nucleic acids, nitrogen bases and pentose sugar and inorganic phosphate. All these substances also, these substances also transported through the secondary active transport from here they transported into the bloodstream through the simple diffusion. Okay, coming to the lipids. So, see, in the lipid, there is a short length fatty acid. These short length fatty acids that from the lumen to the small intestinal cell, that is epithelial cells, through the process called as a simple diffusion. These short length fatty acids that enter into the bloodstream through the simple diffusion. You can just see what are the substances that are enter into the blood. glucose, galactose and fructose, amino acids and nucleotide substances. All these substances that enter into the mix in the blood. But long length fatty acids, monoacylglycerols and glycerols. These three substances that are not enter into the bloodstream, that opens or enter into the lacteal. I already mentioned lacteal is a lymphatic vessel. Lymphatic vessel which is present in the epithelial cells, which is contacted with the epithelial cells. Let us see, this is somewhat difficult when compared to the all the above substances. So let us see, actually monoacylglycerols, long length fatty acids and glycerols, these glycerols, monoacylglycerols, let us see, that initially combined with the bile salts, initially combined with the bile salts and forms the micelles. Bile salts along with the phospholipids, they forms the missile like structure. This is the round like structure. These are also called as the droplets in the water of the lumen of small intestine. So these substances, missiles that enter into the these epithelial cells through the process simple diffusion. This simple diffusion subjected these missiles enter into the these epithelial cells that contains the endoplasmic reticulum. From the lumen to the missiles enter into the endoplasmic reticulum, where the endoplasmic reticulum can convert the monoacylglycerols into the triacylglycerols. We know very well this is a monoacylglycerol, triacylglycerol. This is a triacylglycerols. So that converted into the triacylglycerols by the action of endoplasmic reticulum. Again, these endoplasmic reticulums synthesized these triacylglycerols and cholesterols, all are packed in the protein, that is lipoprotein. It is called simply as chylomicron. These chylomicron enter into the lacteal, not here is a blade, that enter into the lacteal. This is the lacteal. This is the blood vessel. From here to here is the blood vessel. Here to here is the lacteal. What happened? Missiles that enter into the cell. That cell contains the endoplasmic reticulum, produces or synthesizes these chylomicrons. These chylomicrons that enter into the lacteal. In this way, all the substances which are present in the food get absorbed by the different mechanisms which are present in the membranes of the epithelial cell and also membrane of the blood. So, it is clear? Okay. Here one more point to be noted, the micelles that also contains the fat soluble vitamins. So the next topic is assimilation. What actually happened? All the contents that are present in the food that mixed with the blood and also lacteal, all these substances that go to the finally various parts of body. Various parts of body. Then what is the assimilation? It means the utilization of the digested food substances for the various aspects which are essential for the cell growth and development. Let us see the glucose, galactose and fructose. All these substances are absorbed by the various cells of the human and all these are utilized for the oxidative respiration. Oxidative respiration. So, if excess of these carbohydrate moieties that stored as a glycogen in the liver and muscle. Liver and muscle. Next to the proteins, especially amino acids, these amino acids which will utilized for the synthesis of essential proteins, necessary proteins and enzymes. Nitrogen bases and inorganic phosphate and pentose sugar of the nucleic acids are utilized for the synthesis of the nucleic acids. Synthesis of nucleic acid, especially DNA and RNA, deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. Finally, lipids. We know very well the lipids in the form of triacylglycerols, which are digested by the lipoprotein lipase, which are present in the veins of the large vein, where the actually lacteal is opens. And finally, that converted triacylglycerol into the monoacylglycerol and small length fatty acids and long length fatty acids. All these substances together form a lipid layer in the adipose tissue. In this way, all the substances of the food that converted and absorbed, assimilated and utilized for the various aspects. In this way, complete digestion of the food into the various monomers, that monomers into the final utilization. Okay, I think it is clear.